Hello, my beautiful Pisces friends. Happy holidays. Hope everyone's doing well. We're here for a love reading for Pisces. Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna, and this is Irish Donna Tarot. So let's cut this deck and see what the overall energy is for our Pisces friends in love. Well, Pisces, there you are. Ten of Cups, happily ever after, a love relationship, marriage energy. The Hangman, Pisces, oh my, okay, Ten of Cups, Pisces, Hanged Man, Pisces, Moon Card, Pisces, what is going on? You are looking at things from a very different perspective. You're searching for answers. You're searching for enlightenment. You have felt unsure about something that's going on in this relationship. So let's see what the energy is for your mutual love interest in you in the recent past. Justice card. That can be a card of you have a marriage or you're really thinking about it. You are thinking very seriously about marrying this person. This is a person that you love very much. Justice card is the marriage license. It can be buying a home together. It's any legal paperwork, but it's also very balanced. Libra energy, seventh house on the astrology wheel for the house of marriage. Scorpio energy and ending in a new beginning. Deep love. Feeling as though both of you love each other very, very much. Now, I don't think that you're the type of couple that's ooey gooey. I think that you really show your love in a very direct, very kind, loving ways. It's a card of being very serene emotionally in the relationship. Both of you are very stable in this relationship. How does your person view you? They view the situation as seeking enlightenment, Virgo energy. So there may be something going on to do with the job here, but Virgo energy is searching for answers. So your person isn't quite sure how things are going to unfold. How do they view you? Hardworking, somebody who's very easy to live with, to deal with, that somebody they enjoy being around. They feel as though day-to-day life with you, Capricorn energy, has a lot of stability, a lot of pleasure. You may have a dog or a child, but it's almost like a Three Musketeers card, but it really says that your person sees you as one who builds things, one who is a creator, one who creates stability in the relationship, somebody who's like a master planner. In their heart space, Pisces, they love you. You're the one, tiki torches, starry nights. You're the person that they want to ride the surfboard with. They want to go to exotic places. This is Aries energy, Capricorn energy. They think that you're the one. How they view the situation going forward. The alchemist, the magic that the two of you can create together. It starts with the Three of Coins. We have this Sagittarius energy, very much the energy of being calm, cool, collected. We can make it work. Optimism, happiness. Archangel Raphael protecting the relationship. The mutual energy that's hidden between the two of you. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. You are enjoying a very glorious time in your relationship. That is a card of success, of being in the limelight, adulation. You might want to make a public pronouncement, introduce each other to friends. You're at a very successful time in this relationship. Oh, look at this. The Honey, I'm Home card. Really having the spirit, the courage to, you've earned this relationship, Pisces. Spirit is saying, go for it. That's the Emperor riding the chariot, Cancerian energy, powerful energy of home and hearth and fighting for everything that you want in your family relationship. The Outcome card, a brand new beginning in love. For some of you, I feel as though there's a big shift in the energy. I feel like you've been making plans and now you're manifesting those plans. So, absolutely outstanding energy. Okay, so let's see, Pisces, what is going on here with the energy? Why do we have the moon card? Why is this feeling of, there's a fear of the unknown almost. That's what I'm reading this as. You're on this wonderful adventure, and it looks as though you just don't know what's going on. So there we have the Seven of Cups energy. That is Scorpio energy. So there's a lot of changes that can impact your relationship going on around you. Both of you are staying very alert. Oh, the King of Pentacles, there's new stability coming in. Great, that's the Hanged Man. You've been waiting for this. You're manifesting something with your love partner that you've been planning and waiting for to happen. The Ten of Coins, legacy, marriage energy. That is creating an abundant life together. The King of Pentacles is often involved in this kind of energy, but the two of you are rock solid with each other. You are Taurus energy, Virgo energy, making plans for the future, not knowing what the future brings, but look at what just fell out. The two hearts beat as one. The Two of Cups, minor arcana, soulmate. The High Priestess card means that both of you are operating a very high vibrational level. You're not talking a lot. You've made these plans. And look at this. We have the Virgo energy sun. Yeah, I don't know if you're going to the sunshine state, but this, you know, I see adventure, ocean, success, limelight, somebody in the public eye. The Five of Wands. Well, you have a lot of choices. You have competing ideas. So you are searching for answers. Your person is keeping their own counsel. They do share things with you. Your person does share. Even when they go quiet and they're in a planning mode, it shows that they, you know, they have concerns about the plans that they've put in place. You know, there's a little bit of inner conflict or inner turmoil that your person has because they want everything to turn out perfectly, and they are a bit of a worrywart, which is common to Virgo energy. This person is very, very determined to make this work out. Heart of Swords, Queen of Swords energy. That's a Libra queen, Libra energy here. And leaving something behind. But I'm going to tell you, I feel as though many of you are moving possibly to a different place. The Eight of Cups is also a travel card. I know a lot of people don't read it that way. In fact, I might be the only one. But I traveled for a living professionally for many years as a crew member, an international crew member. And that Eight of Cups is, we leave what we love behind, but we always return. So you may be returning to a place that you met. You may be returning to a place that you love, or you may be going back to a place that feels like home, creating a new home, leaving a place that you didn't like so much behind. The Three of Coins is clarifying the Three of Coins, executive decision making, executive planning. The Three of Wands, clarified by the Ace of Cups. Again, a new opportunity for love. The Ten of Cups, clarifying that you have made the right decisions. Anything that you were worried about looks like you're having a manifestation that is off the charts beautiful. Wonderful energy. Six of Wands, why is it here? The Hanged Man, well, you're waiting for that success to turn up. You know, there's something that you're definitely waiting to see. Wait and see attitude, but it's very Cirque du Soleil energy. You know, Pisces, you're very powerful. Look at this, a Strength card, Leo energy. There may be somebody here who is very much in the center of the limelight. We see a lot of that. The infinity symbol. You have fire in your belly, driving this chariot forward, driving a car forward. I see this sense of adventure, this new beginning in love, in a stable relationship. Again, makes me believe you change locations. We also see the Justice card is clarifying the Ace of Cups. You find out that this new beginning is going to culminate possibly in you taking that leap of faith into a marriage. Okay, so I want to find out just a little bit more about the Pisces energy here with the Moon card. This is exquisite. I don't even know how much more I could say. This is a fabulous reading. This is like planned. This is culmination. This is, you know, this is manifesting at the very basic, most basic levels. Plan, execute, and enjoy. Okay, tell us more. Aw, twin flames. You are twin flames, the 1111 card. Whatever happened, there's a strong Pisces element or tie between the two of you. That's the card number 22, the Ace of Wands. So whatever fears that you've had between the two of you or alone, Pisces, this is an absolutely beautiful, just fulfilling, joyful, happy reading that you both deserve. You did the work. You found the balance. This is a relationship that's been successful for a long time. You might have known each other up to 10 years, but at least, you know, a year, 10 months, the last 10 months has been great. Prosperity, that is what you're manifesting. This success card is going to give you prosperity in this relationship. Going with the flow, good. There's our moon energy. Going with the flow, we see the little moon in the background. The daylight is shining through. There's a certain magic here. Transcending Pegasus energy, transcending any difficulties of the past, and we have activation of your guardian spring, the spring of your life, a new growth, new success, and focus. The Wizard of the Woods, focus. Both of you focused with this Three of Pentacles energy on a master plan, and at the bottom of this deck is generosity, maple spirit, beautiful. Oh my goodness. Pisces, you had the best reading this week. I'm so excited for you. I am broadcasting from Chicago. I don't know where you are on the map, but please tell me where you're from in the comments below, and I hope to see you in another reading. Sending love, send some back. Bye-bye, Pisces.